Elizabeth Planning Board sidewalk, the project at 287 Ocean House Road. Did I get it all?
Can you say the date again, please?
It is May 26, 2020. So we're here to engage in a sidewalk, and the purpose of the sidewalk is for the planning board to see the physical parameters of the project, ask any questions about the actual physical dimensions or objects or anything pertaining to the application. It is most specifically not to have any kind of substantive discussion about the project. So given that we all have to stand far apart from each other, if you have questions, please speak loudly and as clearly as you can through your mask. Okay? So I'm going to turn it over to Jim and Alyssa. Alyssa, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. What I'd like to do, just for purposes of only three today, we'd like to do a walk this way, walk over to the intersection, down the sidewalk, over to where this entrance is, just turn around the end of the building, take a drive behind it, and then come back here, since I think predominantly the entrance is going to be where the building is out. But still want to try to get to what your vision site to be. Driver's seat is approximately 6 feet back from the portion of the car that's on the road. This kind of landscaping right here is generally tall enough that it could be obstructed if you needed to see through that to be able to take a look at any oncoming traffic. We don't have that. And to the extent that you're interested in this a little bit later, just pull out, or any time, pull your car up to that stop bar, and when you're the first queue in line, look down here and you'll see that there is a clear line of sight. So as far as traffic sight line impediments, we really don't have it for that. We'd like to point out traffic accidents in the 3-year period for this intersection involved cars coming out of Scott this direction on Scott Dyer from the shooting area in the middle of the year. Right up about where that solar angle. Director of Public Works usually takes care of it.
Alright.
And I did talk with Bob last week, he's got a lot on his mind obviously, but about this, and he said, as far as he's concerned, feel free to talk to him, he would rather have these shaped than removed. And we don't really need to remove them from a safety perspective, so, and they're not badly shaped right now, but we would be happy to come out here and even though it's not our property well enough close to our property to be consistent.
Give you a spatial idea, the aisle width for the bathroom of the gold fire over here. The aisle width is 24 feet.
There'll be a little bit of landscaping right here, but this is also where the sign's going to go, and the entrance, the parameters of the entrance are going to extend out considerably further, basically a full parking room from here. So you're looking at about 18 feet up to the back of the sidewalk, quarter of a mile. This entrance, as well as this entire entrance, while we're going to approve them, they're going to stay where they are. This is approximately 300 linear feet from that intersection that you looked at. The distance from the other intersection. We've got Cobra lights overhead all the way up and down the road. So this light right here, that light built by the flagpole over there where we first gathered by the intersection, that's coming out because that's going to be in the middle of nowhere. It doesn't need anything. And then the light pole that's over there, we'll see that over there when we get it in the far corner. That'll be coming out as well. That's lighted also from across the way. The only light pole that's sitting, you can't really see it right now because it's in that tree, but the only light pole that we're proposing to stay for security reasons is right over here. We'll walk to that here in just a second. Questions so far?
Yeah, last meeting, Joe mentioned an idea of a path that was going through.
Yep. Nope, we're going to show that.
Okay.
Yep, and that's going to cut right straight through the gate, almost at the end where the deep pavement is right now, straight across the grass field, and then almost directly across from the front gate. Okay, let's head back over the side. There's another shed, Dr. Michael and he was like, originally going to be facing different from the new shed out there. He just said it's not working, so they're doing something except that he can't address it. Standpoint, it's easy just to be able to pull it right up here. And it's all electrical, it's all battery operated. So it's pretty well put on. There may be, if you don't have any, there's no record of anything in here as far as where your septic or sewer line was. It's kind of tough to get. You'll see a couple of them. Some of them are electrical in the hole, but the one that's over in the corner over there, because obviously that's going to hold the doors. We just don't plan on going there. DEP says don't go there. You know, we can pave right over the top of this stuff. So. don't think we'll do that, but we'll leave it accessible in case the beauty is there for some reason. From an excavation standpoint, we just don't want it going there anymore. That's why when you do some of the landscaping in the rear, somebody had the question about building up a little bit. We'll be removing the skein of pavement, and then we can always add earth in this area, we just can't take it away. So we will add that just a little bit over there to the grass and then some more factors. Is that your question?
So, I mean, this says sewer.
Yep.
But it's not back to the
sewer. Well, I mean, the sewer goes out the other way. For a septic system. It could have been for a breach shaft of some sort, but as you can see, it's kind of sealed in there with the asphalt. And if you talk to the DEC about that, they said, your property, you can do what you want, but if you don't have to go there, don't. And don't pull anything out of it. So, it's not wherever it was, it's not the germane to the region. So, I'm very likely to be coming up, and you'll see where it's coming up. Okay, we walk on front of the building. This is the wing that we talked about the other night. This wing will actually come off. But the other wing on the other side of the car over here will stay on.
Jim, can I ask you a question?
They would end up parking directly towards that car if there wasn't something to help them. I watch it all day.
Yes.
Ryan, you want it for your house?
If you want a roadie, you can come over to Dave's. Okay, the secondary means of egress, obviously, but you could see on Saturday you might see more traffic than over here. So typically it's 100 traffic. So we expect it to come from there, but you still got this. I want to propose to leave it as three lanes. I think I touched on this before, the 50-foot lane, particularly at the commuting distance, or just past the school distance, or school drop-off time and the commuting distance. You can start to get some long queues over here. So instead of, rather than like this one down here, we've actually got two exit aisles, one left, one right, so somebody doesn't have to get too impatient. People do what they want to do, et cetera. So we've got one in, two out, right down here. That pole is leaving, and the whole parking lot. So you've got basically, I'm going to show you over here. You can see here. Other than that, as far as the site, questions? I talked about the building.
You said that light is going?
Yes. We'll have a wall pass straight to the lake here. Want the building to go over.
Jim, one question I have with the
typically, yes, because it's already there. The problem we have is we can't do a lot of excavation. We could get away, if we have to move something to point that at, we could probably do that.
Yeah.
We just have to be very cognizant of the fact that we can't really dig.
Yeah, and you're just, this striping, I just want to make sure, that's just going to be paint on the asphalt. You're not building it up or anything like that.
Nope, painting on the asphalt, that's correct. Okay, so as far as the building is concerned, Michael was going to come over and give us the key, but his partner, who spends a lot of time in here trying to design stuff and inside, et cetera, has a very young child who is apparently immunocompromised, so he asked if there's nothing wrong to see from the side of that building. You're more than welcome to kind of worry there, really stick your head in if you want to. But from an official standpoint, he was excluded this evening. We've got the photographs to be able to show you if anybody is interested. You can trash these when you're done. And this basically shows anybody going to pick up with the information about the building.
Is this a new
car? Yeah, you can throw it down. You can
throw it.
Things are kind of shaped windows, so there's nothing behind them. They're just kind of a painted on or
the windows are, you say?
These aren't real. Yeah. With a sign on one side and the other.
Built all over?
So what would, I guess, be part of
that?
You can see the edge of the block.
Right, no. I acknowledge that you can see a block right here, but I'm confused about
why. Oh, why is wood under there?
Yeah, no, but it's wood all on the cinder block.
It's just to run it for this stuff.
Right, but Joe, they said it was all block. That's why I don't think it's block. This right here is a block.
This, I think this is a 12-inch block, and that's how the 8-inch.
Okay, well, let's see, because I just...
So this is a cross, this is a crossbow gun. Well, it's 12 inches, right? And then the block sits back, and you have room for this stuff to go attached to the block.
Yes, they just walked that out.
kind of makes sense.
So is this your cultural event?
That's brand new.
This is not. And that's from all the gas tank, all of the old dispensers. So that's not.
But I have, I'm looking at this with the header right there. So to me, that block right there is not what the structure is. Except for you got to, I don't know if that's
tied
in there.
Yeah, but it's in line with that back there.
Yeah.
This is a whole nother, this is probably 2x framing.
Yeah.
Stuck
so this
out.
This would be the other side, which is much clearer. So you have the block, and then they have openings in the block that they've kind of framed over. Right. So I don't know exactly what happened on this side, but it does look like my transition into just a different framing system.
Can you remind us what was in this corner?
What's the bathroom?
That's the bathroom where the current utility is.
Okay.
And the bathroom, has the bathroom been ripped down in this picture?
The other wall, I think, was with the plumbing.
Right. But
wouldn't it be nice to be able to get inside, wouldn't it?
Yeah, this is the issue. We can't come and sort of do a little independent check-in for that would be another site.
Well, Jim, did you say you had a key, but he just wanted people to poke their head in and not actually go in the building?
He was going to come over with a key, and then his partner, as he claimed to be his partner, because he was compromised one day with his daughter, and he requested that nobody go in the building because he spent a lot of time in there. But Mike, it's just an empty building. It's, stuff in there. He has no problem seeing the building.
So, Jim, Mike isn't in here?
Sorry?
Mike isn't in here every day? Yeah.
I don't think they're in here every day, but I think a lot of the days they're in there just kind of throwing for stuff based on information.
It's just that we've noticed Mike's truck here a lot. We've noticed Mike's truck here a lot.
It's parked right over there.
Right.
Yeah. He's not in here every day.
Okay.
I can't speak for his parking at all. I'm not sure.
Okay.
Just to focus, I guess, the conversation. To beautify this, we'll come up with ideas to create more openings or to treat it a little bit more so, but not create a door, because I don't think a door would benefit the side, but it needs something. And I think that's kind of what everyone feels.
Right.
Yeah.
For the record, not everybody. I'm not starting that conversation again.
But I just wanted, you know, if you walk around the building, you see it's limited, whether it's concrete or not. If we have to make an opening, you know, we'll just have to get a structural person to make sure that it all works and it's structurally sound. It's just more difficult. But I think we'll propose some options for the next meeting.
Maureen, could you explain why you have two doors proposed on the front facade?
Just because one is existing and the second one was for function because of the wood.
So I don't think there's anything in the rules that says you have to keep the original door. I mean, what the rules say is that you have to have a distinctive front entrance. It's the planning board's call. I'm just saying that the rule says there should be a distinctive front entrance, which kind of suggests one. And if there's two, that one should be screaming, "I'm the main entrance," and the other one be kind of a subtle one. And it just seems like some of the stuff is we can't make changes, and then, yes, we can make changes. So I just wanted to understand why there were two front doors.
There are two front doors, one for pure function of moving large pieces of wood and one kind of a smaller retail one that seemed easier to keep than to not keep. But if, I don't know, it just sounds like there is pushback for a distinct
front door. Are people going to know not to go on the two on the left? How are they going to know not to go on that door?
Good point.
That's a great point. I mean, you can see a young child go right through the door.
The main doors kind of go into the retail space too,
okay,
and then
so
the end piece is a little bit raised, and that's kind of where we put
it. One of the things you did mention about giving options, the planning board meeting is not really for options. It's to make a presentation and say, here you go, this is what we're thinking. And I know this applicant's not right. Workshop, and then all of a sudden it was on to meetings, and last meeting was just a lot of, okay, what are we going to do next? Here's the options, here's our thought process. To me, I want to see a plan. I want to see something in place. I want the ordinances looked at. I want the details in the plan, as opposed to just sort of a spitball on what do you guys think, this is what we're thinking, how does this feel. So I hope that when this comes back again, that it's really, okay, no, this is the front door. We're going with the front door because of this. We're going with the side, we're gonna have this. I just think that it's really, we need to see a lot more detail in the application, at least this is how I'm feeling. We need to see that when it comes to the planning board. The workshop phase is for, okay, let's try to see what you're thinking, see what we're thinking. I know you're new on this, but I'm just saying.
Just a little new on this, but also hearing feedback at like a distinctive entrance, it is subjective. That we have some ideas and kind of a second plan in place in case that it's just more things to look at, because we want this to be passed. I don't want to drag it out for multiple months. It's not
we don't either.
So,
trust us, we don't. But at the same time, we need to do it on the fly to say, okay, well, we're going to go with option B instead of option A.
Understood,
that makes
it
very difficult to get all the language. I mean, we got sued. The town got sued a couple years ago because we didn't have that distinct language. And the law court or the superior court kicked it back to us and said, do it all over. And we spent more time in the long run doing it like that as opposed to if we had just done it right in the first place. And we just don't want to see that happen. So really having that information beforehand, walking into a meeting and having that ready is really vital to the whole process. Because otherwise we're going to get it kicked back.
I feel like we presented what we would like, and then we heard a lot of criticism that it didn't meet like the distinctive entrance, for instance.
Yep.
And I think the conversation was centered around the subjectivity and how much the planning board wants to see a new proposal. So it's kind of asking for something that we're trying to get, but we'll do better the next one.
Well, and also I would use the town, I would use Maureen as a resource if you have those questions, because
yeah,
she's definitely
okay.
Open to telling you about what in other projects around here. I mean, they went through it, Cecil went through it, people over there went through it. It's all town center. It's very difficult because it's town center. So you can blame Peter for how much the town center put the ordinances together. No, kidding, but there's a lot to it. So.
There's a lot to it, and it's also kind of unclear the existing versus the new construction
right. Yep.
In the language. So we can go back again, and we can make our pitch for what we want, but there has been a lot of feedback on each item, so how many times can, I guess, we go back and forth without having a backup option?
Yep.
Just so that we can kind of move the process along.
I mean, one thing I was promising for this year, come up with your plan, be prepared to wait to respond to the ordinance, to prescribe what has to happen or what can't happen. So, like on the distinctive reference to these things, how many will have a case to be made? What do you think?
Last time we submitted a narrative, it went like line item by line item, but we can do it again.
Okay. Joe?
Anybody else? Jim? Then Maureen?
Go ahead.
I may have missed it in the first few minutes, but explain the sidewalk, what's staying, who's doing what. I know the town did some things.
Sidewalk at Scott is new. Sidewalk at Kirby.
Yeah.
It goes all the way up to the curb and then actually wraps around just a little bit.
Okay.
Stops right about where that yellow pedestrian sign is.
Okay.
And then the sidewalk that's remaining going all the way down the hill stays that way. It's the municipal sidewalk.
Okay.
There was another part to your question.
Were you replacing any of the sidewalk?
No, not proposing to.
And then I guess I don't know how to frame the question on the street lighting, because you pointed that out. And I know we're going to come back to that. And
it's really a substantive issue. I mean, they're not indicated on the plan, so there's not much we can talk about
Can I ask one question on that?
Yeah.
There was an indication from Jim. I thought you said that you thought it would have to be a half dozen, about six lights.
And then we came up before, just by counting the ones that were down here, but somebody at the last meeting would mention one. So I got people's pictures on it, and there's enough of it on the left. That's not a huge issue. It's more of an expense thing for off-site work for a fairly modest project here. Point being said, we did reach out to the Director of Public Works, and he did send us information based on what the rest of these. Well, there's actually a couple of different variances of the lights that you see in here. So he sent us that information. There's no pricing involved in that. He can't really do that. But it's incumbent on us to be able to find that pricing and get that for you. I know economics does not drive the train, but it would be interesting to see what the individual costs are for those. So we will have that information for you.
So you have the spacing of those, the fixtures down the streets?
Well, we took a look at the spacing as it goes down past the dotted strip on the street. So yeah, we've got the idea of the spacing.
All right. Can I ask a question about Portland Marine?
I'm good.
You good?
I can't hear you.
Does the town typically take town property of the what street lights when they're basically out and then the town takes over them?
Yeah, the ordinance says, and it was discussed by the council more than once, and it's not something that landowners jump up for joy, but the ordinance explicitly says that people in the town center, when they come in for site plan review, are required to install sidewalks. The profile for the sidewalks includes an esplanade, street trees, lighting, and a 6-foot-wide concrete sidewalk. Those are typically installed in the public right-of-way. Sometimes there's not enough room in the public right-of-way, in which case we get a public access easement, for example, in front of the Sea Salt Market, where the sidewalk bends in towards the front door. That goes off the public right-of-way, and they provide a public access easement. the town maintains all of the sidewalks and all of the lighting once it's installed. I'm good.
All right. Great. We are adjourned.
Thanks everybody for coming.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.